Have you used Hitbox before?
No.
Okay, it's basically like Twitch TV, but it has, like, no delay.
Oh, cool.
Or, like, a few seconds at most. Okay. Give me a second. So, first thing with Lulu, I think it's better to get Ignite, almost on any support, except situationally, with, like, if you're playing against E or something, and, you know, you basically want Exhaust, but for, like, Lulu, you can always, Polymorph E anyway when he's going in, but if he has, like, QSS or something, it might be good to also have Exhaust in that situation. That's very specific. That I would say. The Ignite usually ends up always being better because you can have more kill potential and whatnot, and you can end up soloing people a lot more easily.
Okay.
So it's just something I recommend. Something I always do pretty much in like 99% of my games. Before we start off, do you have any questions or things you want me to address specifically, or just go through that replay?
Yeah, I guess just tell me, you know, how you feel.
How I feel.
As we go.
Okay.
Sorry, I'm socially awkward.
It's okay, we're all socially awkward. We're all nerds who play this game 24/7. Okay. Trying to look up your masters real quick. I see you take, like, Ignite some games, and then other games you opt not to. Have you been, like, did you recently switch to using Ignite? Because that's all the past two games you were running Ignite on support. Or what's the case?
I don't know. I always traditionally heard it was better to take Exhaust, so sometimes I'll take Ignite if I feel like I can kill them early. And then if I don't feel like I'll be able to kill them, then I don't take it.
Okay. Okay, your runes. Wow, you run the exact same runes I do. Nice.
Okay. That's good.
That's good. Wait, is the Karma support page your Lulu page as well?
I think I was trying that one because of the new mastery that came out. It was like exposed weakness or something.
Yeah, that's fine. The only thing that I would switch around would be the lifesteal. You should always get natural talent because the extra AP and AD is used better for support Lulu. You're never gonna really use lifesteal.
Oh yeah, that's true.
Everything else is good. Precision, I guess, situational. But I usually always opt for intelligence because the cooldown reduction, I don't know, I really like the utility from it, but either or is useful. Early on, try to hit minions, because you want to go for the level 2 early on. When Lucian engages over here, or when Tristana engages, you want to be next to her, or closer up, because right now, if Tristana's about to engage on Lucian, Janna's already in position to shield Lucian, but you're not doing any damage right now. So, for about 2, 3, 4, 5... 6 seconds, you're not doing any damage, or 5 seconds, pretty much. Whenever people are fighting, you want to make sure you're there exactly when the fight starts, and then you leave exactly when everybody leaves, because you just want to maximize your DPS and without dying, pretty much.
Okay.
So that's one tip. But you do turn it around and win the trade by a little bit, because Lucian overcommits, so that was good. You have the stream muted, by the way, right? So you're just...
Yes.
Okay, good. Forgot to tell you. But usually people figure it out.
it was echoing.
Yeah. Okay. Okay, as soon as you guys are about to hit level 2, don't be afraid to, like, run up. Janna's already in a slightly awkward position, because, like, you should grab your E level 2 on Lulu.
Alright.
More damage. So, as soon as you're about to hit level 2, Janna is in the awkward position, and they're still level 1. So, this is beneficial for you. One second, let me pull out the paint. Paint is where all the plays get made. Okay. So, she just shielded Lucian, and he's not going to be able to do much right now. Make sure before, even if your AD carry doesn't notice it, ping that you're going to get level 2, or ping that you're going to go in for level 2. People usually understand it. So in this situation, just walk up. Don't be afraid of his shield. All you have to do is either you should probably focus Lucian in this case, because he's closer. But either or, just try to E, and then get your Glitter Lance, your Q, I believe that's what it's called, across both people in this situation. Because Tristana should be getting her rocket jump in this situation, because she's, you know, too far to make any plays, but she can rocket jump in this situation and at least waste their summoners by doing another all-in-ish kind of thing. But it's not so all-in because you guys have a level difference, so you guys win until they get the minion there. Now it's back to being an even lane. So watching for those is really useful. Use the Glitter Lance early. If you had waited to use your Glitter Lance until after he dashed, you would be able to waste his heal in this situation, because Lucian walked up and tried to dive into minions for Tristana. So if you slow him down right here, he's going to take aggro from 4 different minions right now.
Okay.
So more damage dealt from you guys. A lot of this stuff is, like, I would say, hard to see, but the more you practice seeing it, the more often you're going to be able to take advantage of it in lane.
Right.
Okay. Whoa. Okay, so when Janna walked up there, you could have also, like, wasted her flash at least. So she walks up, and in this situation now she's taking aggro from minions. So she's out of mana, so she can't do anything in that, you know, area. And you just W forward, or you don't have W because you're level 2, but you should be juggling around this area, kiting around, because they're here, so you kind of want to mirror where they are. And this is also a good position for you to be in, because Lucian can't, like, if he queues across, he's queuing this way, and if he queues this way, he's queuing to minions. So you have an entire open space right here where you can be kiting around in. And even if you can't get close enough to them, you can E onto this minion and Q Lucian or Q Janna, or even E onto one of these minions and do the same thing. But anyway, so in this position, you should be up here so that in case Janna does something stupid like this, where she's about to start taking aggro from these minions, you can just start dealing all the damage out to her and slowing her down for Tristana to be able to go in. Okay?
Okay.
Makes sense?
Yes. I think I did notice that she was too far up, probably too late to do anything.
Yeah, but if you at least notice it, that's like a start, you know? It's better than nothing.
Yeah.
Oof. Make sure you use exhaust before they do all their damage spells, so...
Yeah.
As soon as Lucian went in and he used his Q, or he dashed in, you could exhaust him right there, because his damage is basically gone for a spell. But again, it's very, like, timing specific. So, I guess you have to just practice seeing it, and then it'll start being, like, second nature to you later on.
Okay.
Okay. I mean, I'm trying to point out as many things as possible, even if you
right,
miss stuff.
Yeah.
Like, I'm gonna have a recording of this on YouTube, so you can, like, go over it and, you know, rewatch it later. if you end up missing anything. But
okay.
If you miss anything, just ask me, or if you need clarification, just let me know.
Okay.
Ooh, tower shot. Careful with that. Okay. You have to react faster. You had Gragas in vision for 4 seconds, and you guys didn't move. Okay, wasted flash. Not wasted flash, you used flash, and then got out. Okay. I would say, whenever you're playing, try to make a cycle of things, like, in your mind, like a mental checklist you want to keep looping over. So, look at minimap, look at their position, look at experience, who's gonna get levels, look at items, you know, just make a mental checklist and keep going, like, looping through that when you're playing, because it'll help a lot.
Okay.
Because once you get into the habit of looking for certain things, it'll help, like, improve your play in the sense of you'll know when you should be going in, or stuff like that, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
Even if you need to put, like, a sticky note on your monitor or something.
Get second screen with a mini-map.
Oh, there you go. That's actually a good idea. Alright, I have 2 screens and I didn't even think of that. I should maximize the mini-map on another screen. Wow, that's genius. Okay. So, I mean, right now you guys don't know where they are. They're probably backed. So, you should just queue the entire wave and shove it, and then tell your ADC to go roam somewhere. At least go get golems or crugs, whatever they're called. More experience this way. Or if Scuttle's open, go over here and grab Scuttle. Or if your mid laner is mid, then go ahead and go mid and try to put some pressure on the tower. If you hard shove it, you're going to have, like, 15 to 30 seconds basically to move around the map before it starts pushing back to you. So always try to take advantage of that. Because you're just sitting here in the bush for like 30 seconds, you're not putting any pressure on the map. So it's better to put pressure on the map than not. Okay. And another thing, so usually the jungler will come get their buff around 7 minutes. So there's no reason right now to... I mean, if you want to be really safe, it's fine to ward here in the river. But you should have waited until like 6:30 or 6:45 to ward over here. Because that way you know for sure, okay, their jungler's probably going to be here in the next minute. Because their buff is spawning, you know what I mean?
Okay.
So, another good thing to keep track of timers. At least in the first 10 minutes of the game, usually jungle paths don't change too much.
Right.
Okay, and then right here, don't let, like, Lucian farm for, like, free. You could always just walk up, kite around, and as soon as you see, like, Janna waste her shield or something, or if you want to be really trickshotty, Eon one of these minions, one of your minions, or if you don't have any, Eon one of their minions, and just like flick shot your Q to Lucian as fast as you can before like Janna can react. Because that way you're doing more damage harassing, and like you're full mana anyway in lane, so might as well use your mana to do something. So again, here, like, he's farming for free under tower without getting punished. Ooh, and you ran. Since they didn't know you were in the bush, you should have just held that position and, like, waited until he's about to ward into the brush, Q, E, and then, like, auto and use your W to get away. Because proccing Thunderlords is, like, it'll burst Lucian for, like, it's the quarter of his health right now if you land E, Q, and auto.
Yeah. Looking at this, it seems like we're really afraid of them, and I don't know why.
Yeah. Should never be afraid. If you can make them afraid of you, then you know you start winning. After you polymorph him, you don't need to exhaust him because he's not doing anything. Always try to space out your spells because polymorph and exhaust are basically the same thing. You polymorph, and then since Trisana rocket jumped away, there's no need to use exhaust there, so that was just wasted. Okay, and right here, Janna used her shield. You can outtrade Lucian. You have Thunderlord's Decree up. All you have to do is EQ and then auto, and then if you really need to, either polymorph him or W yourself and get away before he can outtrade you with his combo. Like, you can play Lulu really aggressively. That's how I like playing Lulu. Gotta take advantage of every little thing. Make people afraid of you. Since you guys have double Yordle bot anyway. Show the power.
Yeah, the Tristana is actually my good friend, so we do a lot.
Well, don't be afraid. Try to, like, both you guys should know how you guys play like each other's playstyle, and then play that way.
Yeah.
Okay, so, real quick thing. So right here, oops. Okay. Wait. Okay, so right here, when you know Janna hasn't used her shield, don't walk up to Lucian. You're not gonna win the trade. The only thing you can do is Q from a distance, and then if Janna's not fast enough, then you win the trade. If she's not fast enough with her shield, or if she is, then you guys cancel out spells. But walking up to him right here, huge mistake. Because you just get chunked and you can't win the trade. And then here, as soon as Lucian dashes, he already used his Q on you, and he already dashed, and he's focusing Tristana. You can go back in here and focus him, and even kill him. Because he's not going to be able to chunk you for 300 that quickly, and he's focusing Tristana anyway. So more time for you to deal more damage. It's a game of maximizing DPS. Okay.
Yeah, we were really afraid of them.
Yeah, but you can see now, like, you have so many opportunities to not be afraid of them.
Yeah.
So just work on looking for those opportunities. So, I mean, Lucian and Janna, like, I would say, are low skill floor to pick up, at least. Because it's really easy to shield and Lucian just press Q and then out-chunk you guys. While you have to land your spells and know when you can go in and chunk them. But it's definitely more rewarding on your side, I would say.
Yeah. I like Lulu a lot. She's probably my favorite.
I agree. Lulu, number one champion. At least out of my support pool.
Yeah. Second favorite would probably be Nami.
Wow. That's so generic. Too many people like Nami.
Oh, I love Nami. She's so good.
What about Draven? Come on.
Draven support?
Oh, no. Okay. Hold on. I thought you meant, like, any champion.
Oh.
If you've been any champion, then yeah, Draven. If you mean supports, okay, we'll accept Lulu.
My friend was, like, dead set on making Misfortune support a thing for a while.
She's good. She was good. At least until they nerfed her E. I used to do her, like, APMF support a lot. She was actually really strong. I would say strong on the same level as Lulu in lane for damage. Huh. Just because her slow is ridiculous.
Yeah.
You can get Thunderlords off. But then they nerfed Thunderlords and they nerfed her E, so she doesn't do as much damage now. I mean, the slow is still there, so that's good.
I haven't seen anybody else, like, talk about it, so I thought he was just crazy.
No, it was completely viable. I did it a lot with my friend, and we played on Smurfs and got them all the way to D5, playing, like, wow. MF Vayne bottom.
Oh, that's painful.
Oh, it is painful when they're, like, they underestimate the APMF support. Okay. Okay. If your jungler's coming in, you can pick some interesting paths. So, okay. So before you walk the lane, you see already see Rek'Sai is coming down. So.
Yeah, I'm pretty sure in this instance I just didn't see her. I didn't notice her coming.
All right, it is a her. God, I keep forgetting. Okay. So they have vision of you all the way here, but if you would have walked to lane coming this way, all you would have had to do is go around because it's not warded for them, besides the river brush, and you would have come with Rek'Sai around the same time, and they wouldn't know that you were coming. So this is like a good way to surprise them and go in and basically burn some sums or even kill both of them. So another path to think about. Okay. Then you guys went too deep. If you're fighting into minions, it's usually never a good idea to go for that. Yep. Okay. So even if like your team doesn't notice it, always just. You have to be, somebody on the team has to notice it, right? So you have to make sure that you're the one, like, carrying your team, even by noticing these kind of things. So just ping people back or whatever, if they're overcommitting or something like that. I mean, I think as long as you don't type, the amount that people actually get mad will probably be kept to a minimum. Because usually if you type anything, your team gets mad. Okay, nice. Okay, nice. You queued the wave. Okay, now you're going back. Why? No reason for you to go back. What, you're trying to go for the one minion?
yeah.
Yeah, agreed.
And it died before I got there. Remember this?
Oh, you died here?
No, the minion died before I got to
it. Yeah. I was like, how did you die? Okay, but anyway, so, perfect situation. As soon as you guys kill him, just turn around and go for dragon. Easy objectives to grab. And then if you would have been there in time, you could have gotten another assist. Ah, but alas, the minion is calling your name. But anyway, so... right after you guys get dragon here, go back bottom and then shove it real quick. You can leave dragon early here, you don't have to stay the entire time, because you already know that two people on their team are dead. Or were dead. Okay, so okay, you go mid, this is fine too. Nice.
Oof. Oh yeah, that happened.
Unlucky. Could have exhausted, but definitely not worth because you aren't going to gain much from that situation anyway. Okay.
Gragas was ganking a lot. We probably should have.
Yeah.
Placed he was coming.
So, in this situation, you have to still make sure you do damage before you die. So right now you're running away, you have your Q up, and you don't use it. And you also have your W up, which would have saved you. But that's besides the point. So if you sped yourself away, you would have been okay. But if you had also used your Glitter Lance on Olaf, he'd be dead right now. So he gets away with, like, what? 52 health. So if you had done just one auto attack worth of damage, or Q'd once, your team would have had another kill. So, again, maximizing damage in all situations is very useful. Took a long time to buy. Okay, their team is shoving bot. Yeah, I should have just gone bot to begin with. To freeze the wave early on and then shove it back in their direction. Okay. So you should, if Tristana is good at like lasting minions, you could have queued that entire wave and shoved it even faster. But I'm not sure how much you can trust your duo partner. So at least you could have queued the back line, the range minions, and shoved it faster. Because right now, he wastes, or she wastes, I'm not sure. He or she wastes another like 5 seconds staying bot when you could have been shoving. And then you shouldn't have rotated there. You should have just shoved it another wave. And then that would have forced their team to come bot earlier. And that would have also been beneficial because your minion wave would have like hit their tower, and it would have this minion wave, their minion wave, would also interact with the first minion wave a little bit, which would cause their wave to start pushing against yours in like the most minimum possible situation, which would cause a huge wave to come down to your lane. But that means Lucian is going to be getting denied farm. So he's going to lose like 4 or 5 waves if you guys would have done that. But I mean, this is okay too, because now it's starting to push towards them. But you guys lose a wave for it. Well, more than one wave. So what I'm trying to say is, at least with the wave pushing, because I don't think that was too clear, was you have two options. And you have to think about your two options. Do you want it to immediately push right now, and then you guys get some gold for it, and then force somebody on their team to immediately go bottom? Or do you want to delay it so that it starts slow pushing, and then a minute and a half from now to 2 minutes, somebody on their team is forced to go bottom, or else your wave takes out a tower? So, wait, hold on. And then the third situation was, if you push it all the way to their tower and then starts shoving to yours, that means you have to make sure in the next 2 minutes you don't have any objectives to take. They're on the top side of the map. So, I mean, if their team was good and the bottom wave was shoving to your tower, then they'd be going for Herald, which means your top lane has to react by going bottom and then your team going for Herald or trying to interrupt it because your top laner has TP. So that's one situation. The other situation is the one you created, which was now your wave is shoving, and now in the next minute or so, their bot lane has to respond appropriately. But the pros and cons here are, if your wave is pushing, you guys are going to lose 3 or 4 waves of minions. So you guys have to do something with that this time you're wasting right now. So that means you guys either go for Herald in the next minute or two, or you go for a mid or a top objective.
Okay.
Does that make sense?
Yeah, that makes sense.
Whoa. What is going on? Okay. Because wave manipulation is like one way to subtly like win the game or put it in your favor all the time.
Yeah. That's something I've been trying to understand more.
But did you understand what I was trying to tell you, or?
Yeah, okay. That makes sense.
Because, let me do some extra drawing, just to make sure. Because, I mean, a lot of people have questions about, like, the wave thing, and they don't understand. So, if your minion wave freezes on any part of the map that's, like, over here, basically ends up that it starts pushing towards their side because your minions get to reinforce faster than theirs. And this works only if their wave is fresh. So that means you guys get 6 minions and they get 6 minions. And then they meet like at this point. That means your wave is going to start slowly pushing, assuming the tower isn't here. That means they'll start shoving to them. Same thing on their side. So if your wave of 6 meets their wave of 6 right here, their wave is going to start pushing towards you because their minions reinforce faster because they can get faster to this location than your minions can get there. And so what I was saying with the minions earlier was if you shove six minions and they meet their six minions, so they're gonna meet here. That means their wave gets frozen around here, and also they take your wave takes tower damage. So their wave is gonna start having more and more minions, and it's gonna shove to towards your tower, which was your secondary tower at that point in the game. But you left it here, and then it met their six minions here. So then it started shoving towards their side, which is what's happening in the game right now. Does that make
Okay,
sense? Is that that's like
yeah.
a simplified version? So that should.
So you're saying we should have like pushed it up further?
Pushed it. So I'm saying you have two options, and you have to know how to
Right.
play around these two options. You push it up. And then it's gonna start shoving to you, so you're gonna have to react in the next 2 minutes.
Oh, okay.
Or you let it push, which is what you're doing now, and then they have to react to it. But means you guys have to take advantage of an objective because they have to send somebody bottom right now. So the appropriate thing in this situation was to not fight here because not only are you guys losing minions bottom, but like your only advantage is to wait for bot lane to start pushing. So now, like in this situation, they're gonna win the team fight because not everybody on your team is here, or you die. It's a poor time to fight.
Yeah.
So in this situation, you guys should have waited another minute because then they would have forced somebody would have had to go bottom, and then that would have started shoving, and then you guys would be in a prime situation to actually fight. But they're ahead of gold. Had in gold because they were able to push their at least their bot lane was able to push it further while you guys left it to start pushing towards them. So they're like in a small gold advantage right now. If you look actually at the gold, Lucian's 200 gold ahead and their Janna is 170 gold ahead, or 160-ish. So 400 gold, it's not much, but it will make a difference with like potion and whatnot. The jump forward. Okay, but so what happened in this situation is they won. Not only did they win the team fight, but now as soon as their bot lane or whoever spawns, they get to go bottom and farm this entire wave. So they come out with more gold again than you guys do, because now you guys have lost all of these minions that were here. And you weren't able to do anything with the pressure you have from the minions building up bot lane. So now Lucian's going bottom, and he's gonna be able to get the tower before the wave gets there. But if you had pushed it to the tower, the wave would now, in this situation, be at your tower, and you guys would be farming it because their team can no longer take any objectives because you guys kind of went even in the team fight. Kind of even enough so that they didn't take any objectives.
Yeah.
Okay. So now, if you look at the gold difference, okay, Tristana got kills, so they're actually equal now. But Lucian was able to catch up. Let's see how much gold. So Lucian was down 300 gold after that fight compared to Tristana. And now, because bot wave is pushing, he ends up being able to catch up to Tristana just because of that. So, 300 gold right there. 300 gold mistake. And then their Janna is there. Still with like the same gold difference as before. She hasn't been doing much. Okay, so dragging the minute, people in low elo usually like definitely 100% like fight for dragon all the time. So try to group around that. So this is a good time to start warding, the brush areas around here, or putting a ward somewhere up here.
Okay.
You want me to pause?
Oh yeah, someone's knocking. Sorry.
Okay, you're good.
Okay, sorry.
That's all good. Okay. So.
I mean, it's fine if, like, he can hear me. Sorry.
You're good.
Yeah.
Okay. So now you go back bottom. You should help shove, because they're not grouping mid, so you don't have to immediately switch. Okay, but this is good.
Is this
And
bad?
it game being good. Because Gragas is completely out of position, having no idea what he's doing. Okay. So, if you Glitter Lance the
Okay.
waves, if you would have done it earlier,
How much longer is
the wave would already be like frozen down here. So that would be more advantageous for you guys because that means either if they start getting dragon now or as soon as you guys get dragon in the next like minute or so, the wave would already be starting to shove towards their tower. So that means a secondary objective for you guys to go after, post dragon. But now it's going to take longer to shove because the wave froze over here, and now it's pushing towards you guys because they have more minions. And like, I want to focus on wave control a lot with Lulu because it's like her strong point. Like her Q being able to clear waves so like fast is like why Lulu I feel like is one of the biggest game changer supports. Just because she has the power to control waves, whereas like usually it's mostly ADCs who can do anything, not really the support.
Yeah. It's really not something that I think about too much, to be honest, so that's definitely interesting.
But you have to like your plays have to revolve around these sort of timings. People in low elo usually don't respond appropriately all the time to them, but you can force them to respond to the obvious ones by, you know, doing the minion wave shoving so that it gets to their tower and then they have to send somebody back. Obviously, like first and foremost, you want to work on like mechanics and your combos. But besides like positioning and lane and whatnot, usually rotate properly. So that's something you don't usually see people do well in this elo.
Cool.
So get that out. Okay, and then here again, you should be queuing the wave, and then Kayle would farm it more quickly, and then it would get to the tower.
Okay. I think usually I hesitate 'cause I don't want the laner to complain like
You're as long as you go in before they damage it, you can queue the entire wave, and before you have Murillo and Rabadons, your queue will not kill any minions in the wave. So they shouldn't complain.
Okay, that makes sense.
But it should be a lot of like grouping mid, like tell people blah, 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 to actually group mid for these kind of things. Because especially when Morgana was there by herself, you guys could have shoved it and then started taking more, like doing more damage to their tower. And even though it might not count that much, maybe you guys do only 100, 200 damage to the tower, eventually it adds up. And it's better than not doing anything.
Yeah, we're going for dragon.
Okay.
Oh, why did I sweep that bush?
Yeah, the regrets. So as soon as you saw, okay, here's another trick you can do. Okay. He TP's in. Now everyone's running away. Okay. You have Vision of Lucian. And the rest of his team has to be coming right now. Okay. They start going down. And now the rest of your team goes down. Bring out the paint. Okay, so. In this situation, when they're all coming down for dragon, don't be over here. Always, like, walk around the walls. Reason being is because now you see their entire team is grouping up and starting to go down, right?
Mm-hmm.
In this situation, all you have to do is, like, Q dragon. It'll come out and start damaging them. And you have three people on your team right here. So they can either start, like, attacking dragon when it gets to here, and then your team can put pressure, which is good. Oops. Or they get off, peel off dragon, and then they have to walk back up where they came from. Because dragon will aggro people around here. So make minions do your dirty work for you. Oh, crap.
Yeah, I died. I think we all died, actually. Yeah.
This Gragas knows how to flash.
Yeah, he was scary.
Seems to be the one carrying their team. TBH. I mean, it was really scary because their team's basically everywhere all the time, kind of.
Yeah.
But you should try to make sure you get wards in... Hold on a second. Depending on, like, if you have vision of their jungler or something, know where they are, or their other laners, you should be trying to get, you know, a ward here or a ward here. Or if you're walking through a river, just put down a ward here. Or if you can get deep enough, put a ward here or here, or in the upper brush, like here. You want to generally, especially when dragon is about to come up, like it's an important objective, at least that people decide to focus on all the time. You want to ward in these areas because you want to make sure you know where their team is coming. In the situation right now where they were going for dragon, you guys didn't have any of these wards, so you didn't really have vision of how many people and who's coming from where. So it would have definitely helped a lot more, and people would have backed off sooner if they knew that Gragas was coming, and maybe you guys wouldn't have died as three in that situation.
Yeah.
Okay. Okay, where's the Q? Oh, there we go. Nice. Got it finally. Okay. But their team is grouping mid. You should rotate right now. Your team doesn't have too much wave clear. This tower is already full of health anyway, so it's going to take a long time to clear. You could have just, like, left Tristana to stay here, because you do wave clearing already, so you could have helped your team sustain towers a little bit more. I don't know what their team is doing, because they're screwing up for no reason, but regardless, just play like you would play if their team was playing perfectly. Okay. As soon as you leave Fountain, use W on yourself and just get there as quickly as you can. Might not make too much of a difference, but usually it'll come off cooldown a few seconds earlier, and that might make a difference in like 1 out of 100 games. So,
yeah.
Something to watch out for. Okay. So, in this game, you're going for Aegis, I'm pretty sure, or Banner. One thing, Aegis versus Banner. If they have an AD top lane, you most likely don't want to go Banner, because their top laner can just auto-attack. But if they have an AP top, that's advantageous for you to put down a Banner minion there, because now that means they have to go send somebody AD top to take care of the minion. So, something to look out for. But definitely Aegis in this situation is good, because they have Morgana and Gragas, and Janna does AP damage as well. Not that she does much, but maybe the tornado will kill someone someday, I don't know.
I've done it before.
You've
like
done
once.
It. But see, 1 out of 100 games and 1 out of however many games. It'll maybe make a difference if you have Aegis or not versus that. Okay. Can't miss that Q. You just shielded yourself. What?
I did. Rip.
Okay.
Yeah. I don't know.
So
I got nothing.
Okay. Watch how much damage you miss dealing during this fight. Hold on. Okay, so you shield him. No auto attack. There's no auto attack on Gragas. There's no auto attack on Gragas. You missed the Q. Well, you got Janna at least. Keep going. Okay, you exhaust Lucian. One auto attack. Should have already walked up forward earlier. Okay, second auto attack. You're walking backwards. No auto attack. You should have EQ'd Gragas right here. And then immediately, you should have ulted Tristana. Because now you would have had Gragas here another second earlier. I mean, for another second, you would have taken another tower shot. And then if you had EQ'd Gragas and ulted Tristana, you would have gotten the kill on Gragas in this situation. Okay. So, no auto attack still, no auto attack. No auto attack. Or no damage dealing, because you stop spells to use too. Oh god, just don't. And then. She still lives. But if you had shield. I mean, you used shielded yourself instead of stunning.
Yeah.
Unlucky. One thing. Oh shit. Okay. One thing, If everyone's grouped, then you feel like you're gonna have trouble clicking people, or like correctly. A lot of people forget that you have like the portraits right here above your map when you're playing, right? So you can just use click your spell and then click on somebody, one of the portraits here, and it'll like use it on them instead. And then Alt E or Alt R if you want to use it on yourself, like quick cast on yourself.
All right.
Not sure if you know about those, but they're really useful, I find. Okay. They're backing up. You should switch to mid and then start shoving mid. Minion's going to waste here. So afraid. So, you have Vision here of Olaf and Morg. Okay, what are you gonna buy with 600 gold? Okay. The bracelets, yeah, they don't do much. Okay, so instead of going back right here, you knew their team was going back, or you only saw Morgana and Olaf here. You could have walked out to river, placed a few wards, and most likely been safe. Because you saw two people here, so there's no way that Gragas, Lucian, and Janna are all waiting for you in one of these brushes here. It's highly unlikely, because they just went back because they were low health. So you could have taken this opportunity to go out into river and start warding a little bit more, in case they do go for Baron. Which they most likely will. Going back for the, I don't know, what do you call it? Bracelets or whatever? I don't know.
Crystalline bracer, yeah. Yeah.
Yeah, so that really didn't give you any advantage. Because especially walking onto Baron Pit, when your team is playing from behind, it's really hard to get there without dying. But whenever you do have an opportunity, like the window you just had for 30 seconds, use it, because you're probably not going to have another window to be able to walk over there safely. Oh, ooh, this is so dangerous. So dangerous. Okay. But they don't have vision of you, so you're playing... Okay, now they do. You're playing it well, because you could have supported Kale over the wall. Oh, snap. So in this situation...
Oh my god.
You see what's happening?
Yeah, I died again.
Yeah, you're already dead in this situation. So you have no mid tower here, there's no reason for you to be up here. Since you're getting caught anyway, you might as well run up and waste their time. Because there's a possibility for you to get away if they're bad. So you walk this way when you're like right here. And you have vision of Morg and Gragas. You should just walk straight up. I mean, you would have known Gragas was coming anyway. Because you guys had vision over here.
Right.
But you could literally walk straight up and then waste their time. Because your W gives you ridiculous movement speed anyway. Okay. Back to the part where you're alive. Okay. There we go. You don't care about anybody else. Okay. Since you guys don't have any vision here, and you do see Gragas like over here, might be a good idea to just drop a ward over the wall, and just, I don't know, in case Morg goes for some really risky plays or something, just drop something here, because you guys don't have any vision here, so you don't want to walk out into the jungle and get caught, because Morg is there, and so is Olaf. Okay, so now you see that they're gonna go for some sort of dive. You definitely want to be waiting here. Now, you know for sure that you don't know what the heck they're doing. And then Darius is top, I don't know why he's top, and he's building damage. Okay, he's got this easy rot thing going. Okay. When you see Gragas coming up, just Alt W, so quick cast yourself and speed yourself up. Because there's no reason, like, you wouldn't have died there if you had done that. So you see Gragas, W yourself, or even W him if you feel like you could have done anything. And then there, I guess he just kills you too quickly, because you could have shielded yourself, you could have ulted yourself. You could have ulted Kale or Rek'Sai or someone. But in that situation, it was just the best idea to back up early because Darius isn't there, so.
Yeah. I guess he thought they were all bot, so he was gonna try and get top tower.
Yeah, that's a terrible idea.
Noted.
But don't tell him that, because as soon as you tell him that what he's doing is wrong, he'll get one of two results. AFK or reported because toxic Lulu or something like that.
Well, I'm like 0-5 or something at this point, so he's probably like, yeah, screw you, I'm not listening to anything you say.
Yeah, exactly.
I wouldn't listen to me either. I mean, 0-5 and like, well, Tristana has 3 kills, but this game was terrible.
I mean, it happens, but as long as you learn from the things you could have improved on, you'll be climbing. I mean, the game is basically a game of consistency, so even I will lose a bronze game, you know, every, how many, like, if I play, like, 100 plus games, maybe I'll lose, like, a few, like, 5 or something like that, so it does happen.
Yeah.
But the point is to be as consistent as possible, because that means if you play more games, you should be winning, like, have a positive game, if you're doing everything you can, right? Like, being a positive influence on the game.
Yeah. It's really, these kind of like stomp type games always feel really frustrating, so I guess it's good to see, I don't know, it wasn't like completely hopeless, like there probably was things I could have done.
Yeah, And the thing is, it's like, whenever you play, you have to find all these things that you can do better and do them better. Because even if maybe, you know, harassing Lucian early on by 5 minutes doesn't seem like a big thing, it probably could have changed the game altogether, because maybe you force him to back a minute early and he doesn't, like, complete a BF sword in that time. So he comes back to lane for 5 minutes without a BF sword, so he can't, you know, get a kill in that situation. And it's like certain, like, snowballs in a certain direction. That ends up being more beneficial for you. Snowballs in your favor. Okay, but good here. You took advantage of going to ward. You should just drop, like, several wards here. So, I mean, you don't know that they have a pink in there, but usually they'll sweep, they'll come in with sweeper and get a bunch of wards. So since you had three, just waste it. Since you're going back anyway, why not use all your wards? So one there is fine. Another one, like, here or in this area would be good, because that means if they come in with sweeper, they'll waste it early on and maybe not be able to get the ward on the Baron Brush. So maybe, like, a ward here. Like, make sure you watch out for, like, pink the brush here, because usually there's a pink here in almost every game. So just ward it, like, down here somewhere out of vision from the brush. And then, so another ward here and something like this. So maybe they'll be able to clear these two with a sweeper, but they'll miss this one. Or especially if you put it, like, further away, like here, they won't be able to come in with sweeper here and take out the ward here and then take out the ward here. And then maybe if they still have enough sweeper time left, they'll be able to kill it here. So make sure you spread them out. So that's beneficial there.
Okay.
Darius going for the risky ward kills. Okay. Where does Lulu go?
I went back.
Okay. Clearing the waves. They're not grouping for Baron, which I am surprised, but I guess Rek'Sai dies. Oof. Yeah, there's not much to do here, because your team's not grouping, everyone's dying one by one. You've basically lost the ability to carry the game at this point.
Yeah.
Their team is 10k gold ahead. Not terribly, but I mean, you guys still have, like, a small chance to win if they die, but they'll die or something like that.
I think we surrender as soon as they take the Baron. I think we're just like, yeah, this is...
Oh, yeah.
No more.
Yeah, it just came out. Okay. But, I mean, it wasn't hopeless the entire time.
Yeah, that's definitely true.
Yeah, so, overall tips, positioning in lane. You have to make sure you place yourself in the right spot. So, I mean, against Janna, you don't really have to worry about, like, more bindings or standing behind minions the entire time. You have to worry about basically the opposite of that, because you have Lucian. So stand where minions aren't, or, like, not in direct line. And then punish Lucian as soon as you see Janna using her shield. Because now your combo, your Thunderlord's Decree Q, E, Auto will out-damage him if Tristana is next to you. You can out-trade him if you see him use Q on a wave and Janna use their shield. Then you can win that trade as well by yourself without Tristana. But then that requires you to speed yourself away. Or speed yourself in, do it really quickly, and then get out just as quickly. So that's another thing to focus on. And then wave positioning, so freezing or pushing, since Lulu is so good at doing those at wave control, try to take advantage of those. So the basic ones are either, you know, you're going for objectives, make sure your wave is pushing to their tower, or if you guys are playing defensively, let the minion wave on their side push to your tower, because then you guys will get the gold and they lose the gold. So there's that. And then, so your rotations are okay, and then just worry more about, like, warding in the right spot, because it looks like you're really afraid to go in and put in deep wards, because you always end up putting, like, a few on your side, but never really in their jungle. So just watch out for, so keep up the map awareness, and then watch out where their team is, and try to pick opportune times to actually put in wards, like, deep into their jungle. and then win the vision game. Okay, so questions.
I'm always bad at this part. Sorry.
It's fine. Take your time.
What about my build?
So your build in this game is fine. It's something I would go. Pretty much the same equivalent. That's fine. Frost Queen, Sidestone, or finishing Sidestone before Frost Queen, Boots, and then going for Aegis because they do have 2/3 APs, and their Gragas is fed, and so there's more Gano. So, I mean, your build is fine. All you have to do is finish Lockett, and after that, I would go Morellos and then Rabadons.
Oh, okay. See, I have had people tell me that my Lulu build is really low AP, so you really do get Rabadons and Morellos?
Yeah. You want 45% CDR, and
right.
You want Rabadons because that's, like, the huge AP spike. As Lulu support, especially in games where you don't need to take Aegis, you want to just go full AP just because it makes you so strong. 45% CDR means like your ult is up every like 40-ish seconds.
Mm.
And then your E, if with 45% CDR, you can infinite sustain it. So if you hold it on somebody or even like yourself, it'll always stay on without whatever coming off. It'll be like 100% on all the time. And then obviously Morello for mana regen as well, that's useful. And then basically with that build, obviously you're really squishy, but you're a utility champion anyway. You don't want to be the one getting focused. Lulu has so much opportunity with her EQ, like she can poke from so far. They should be able to abuse that all the time. There should be another carry on your team that they have to focus first before they get to you. So you should always be fine, and you should stick with your AD carry. Or our Master Yi, if he's your carry, and your ADC is doing bad, then just support, the Master Yi
or
something like that. But like Lulu is really good with DPS champions, like AD DPS champions. I mean, she can support basically anybody, but I would say DPS champions are a little bit more favored to Lulu because you can help them stick to people by giving them speed, giving them a shield. And on top of that, ulting people and then knocking them up, because then it'll keep them in range for whoever your DPS carry is. Plus your Glitter Lance slow is also equally good. But yeah, just a lot of abusing with your Glitter Lance, your EQ, is usually what puts Lulu in a really good position, especially in team fights, because you don't even have to be in the front line. Just like, shield someone on the front line or a minion and just poke a little bit, and usually you can start forcing people out or start a fight. Now, if you manage to get their AD carry already to like 3/4 of the health, that's better than their AD carry being 100% of their health. Because, like, in the situation where you had Olaf mid or whatever and you died, if you just had, Glitter Lance Olaf one time, even that small amount of damage would have completely changed the fight and he would have died. And maybe your team would have had more gold and then the game would have gone in a different direction.
Yeah.
So, just stuff to watch out for, I guess. Any other questions then?
Is there ever a game where you would build like a Frozen Heart or anything like that?
Maybe if they had 4 DPS AD champions on their team.
Okay.
That's like the only time. Usually, like, since Lulu is so mobile, she can always stay in the backline and peel for herself or peel for whoever. So you should never have a problem staying alive. You should never be frontlining with Lulu. Ever. maybe in a situation, some like 1 in 1,000 games where you can like flash, knock up yourself, and then you have Yasuo on your team, and suddenly you get the 5-man Yasuo ult because of that, sure, that's fine. But 99% of the time, you're not frontlining, you're staying in the back and using your EQ to harass, and then peeling for whoever your ADC or whoever your carry is. That's usually what you want to be doing.
All right.
Any other questions?
Masteries, real quick. So you said switch to intelligence, right? Instead of precision?
I recommend intelligence. it will help you sustain your E up to like 100% and shave off like a few seconds on your ult, which maybe will change the game. I feel like I don't really have a game changer when I take precision. I mean, maybe I can deal like 20 or 40 extra damage in a fight, but I never feel like 20 to 40 extra damage in a fight ever wins me the game.
Yeah.
I feel like a few seconds off on like ult and like half a second off on my E or Q usually does more to keep me alive than precision does. But I mean, that's just that's opinionated. So
yeah,
other people will run something different, but I usually go for intelligence. And then also change the natural talent to to natural talent, because you're not gonna use lifesteal or spell vamp as Lulu.
Yeah.
Only if you're leaning as Lulu would I get that. But support Lulu is different.
Alright, cool.
So you changed that. That's good.
Yeah, I made a new page.
Okay. Other questions? If you end up like having like another question later, I'll be like fine to answer it.
Okay.
As well. Like after the session, no problem. So is that everything?
I think so.
Okay. Cool. I'll post the video on YouTube and you can go over it whenever you need to. And then just message me on Skype if you ever have any other questions then.
Okay.
Okay, cool. See you later.
Thank you.